In this explainer, we answer the question, what are mood and figure? First, let's review what is a categorical syllogism and what is standard form for a categorical syllogism. First, a categorical syllogism is an argument consisting of three categorical propositions. For example, all cows are mammals, all mammals are animals, so all cows are animals. A categorical syllogism is in standard form when its elements are ordered as follows. The major premise, which contains the major term symbolized with P, is first. The minor premise, containing the minor term, which is symbolized with S, is second. And the conclusion is last. And remember, the arguments in standard form, when its elements are ordered one on top of the other, rather than in prose style, where we have on the same line the elements one after the other. So let's return to our original argument. All cows are mammals, all mammals are animals, so all cows are animals. And we see that the major term is the conclusion's predicate. The minor term is the conclusion's subject. So the predicate term, P, the subject term, S, will tell us how to order the argument's elements, that is, in this case, how we order the premises. So standard form looks like this, both in terms of ordinary English and using the capital letters S and P for minor and major, and M for middle term. All mammals are animals, all cows are mammals, so all cows are animals. Another way to organize this argument in standard form, as I mentioned just a moment ago, is in terms of the symbolization M, P, and S for middle term, major term, and minor term. Check out the explainer that answers the question, what is a categorical syllogism, for a more detailed account of these technical elements. Meanwhile, let's look at mood. The mood of a categorical syllogism is its proposition type. So remember, three sentences, three propositions make up a categorical syllogism. Each of the sentences will be one or more, each one of the sentences will be one of the four proposition types. So we'll have either A, E, I, or O for the major premise, minor premise, and conclusion, respectively. In our example, notice that we have two universal affirmative premises, that is, two A propositions, and a universal affirmative conclusion, or another A proposition. So the mood is A, A, A. Now let's take a look at figure. The argument's figure reflects the placement of the categorical syllogism's middle term. So in our example, notice that the middle term is mammals. That's the repeated term in the premises. It drops out in the conclusion. Notice the placement of the middle term in the major and the minor premises, respectively. The middle term is in the subject position of the major premise and the predicate position of the minor premise. This is known as figure one, and there are four possible figures. Take a look at the placement of the middle term in each of the four figures. There are no other possible permutations, so we always have only four possible figures, and the numbering you see here is standard. Let's take a look now at the example that we've been working on, and let's put it all together. Remember, the mood of this argument is A, A, A. Here's the argument in standard form with the middle term highlighted. The argument's figure is 1, as you recall from our previous slide. Putting it all together, we get the argument's mood and figure, which is A, 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 1.